Nicholas Berggruen, the homeless billionaire. Nicholas Berggruen had it all. He owned lavish houses, exotic cars, exquisite art and paintings. Oh, and he was a billionaire. The French-born investor had successful ventures in real estate, car rentals, clean energy, and served as an advisor for his family trust. Yes, it seemed like the perfect, exciting, rich man's life. But it wasn't the life for him. Nicholas grew weary and even burdened by the pile of possessions he had accumulated. In 2000, he sold his Manhattan apartment and private island home, gave his collectible artwork to museums on long-term loan, and sold off most of his belongings. Berggruen traded in the sophisticated home base for a private jet and five-star hotels around the world. He became known as the world's first homeless billionaire. As the son of a wealthy art collector, Nicholas was no stranger to high standards of living. He came to the United States to attend New York University and graduated in 1981 with a Bachelor of Science in Finance and International Business. He wasted no time jumping into his career, working in the real estate group for Bass Brothers Enterprises, an investment company. Nicholas later moved on to serve as a principal at Jacobson & Co. from 1983 to 1987. His day jobs were not his only occupations, though. Nicholas worked hard to establish his own real estate investments, a venture supported by his $250,000 trust fund. Fueled by success, he began experimenting with stocks, bonds, venture funds, and hedge funds. He even co-founded a hedge fund called Alpha Investment Management and eventually sold it to Safra Bank in 2004. So, with all of his success, why was Berggruen homeless? While Nicholas sold off his personal real estate properties in 2000, it was not due to financial hardship by any means. As an extremely busy, internationally recognized businessman and bachelor, it just made sense for Nicholas to live in hotel rooms around the world rather than worry about maintaining a permanent home in the States. He could conduct business from every hotel's conference rooms where he stayed while enjoying the lavish five-star lifestyle during his downtime. Though he didn't live in a residential property, Nicholas continued to accrue them. Today, his real estate portfolio includes 70 commercial buildings in Germany, 3,000 apartments in Portland, Oregon, and various properties in India, Turkey, Singapore, and Israel. With his piles of wealth and a long list of successful investments, you would think Nicholas would be satisfied with his position in life. True, he is proud of his accomplishments, but he always felt the need to do more, to make the world better. So, in 2010, Nicholas founded the Berggruen Institute, a self-described think and action tank. The goal of the Berggruen Institute is to reform and reshape government practices and thinking around the world in the name of tackling the biggest challenges of the 21st century. Nicholas and his team have launched many projects since the Berggruen Institute's conception, focusing on global governance system reform. Nicholas's world transformation doesn't stop there either. To keep up his reputation of a billionaire wildcard, albeit an honorable one, Nicholas became a member of the Giving Pledge in 2010 as well. He pledged to give most of his wealth away in the spirit of philanthropy. He established the Nicholas Berggruen Charitable Trust as a vehicle to disperse his wealth to nonprofit initiatives aligned with his vision of shaping a better future for the world. In case the homeless billionaire has not convinced you that he is far from a stereotypical wealthy businessman, this is what he wrote in his letter to join the Giving Pledge. Everyone is dealt a group of cards at birth. With them come possibilities and responsibilities. What one does with them is up to each one of us, and the sum of those choices constitute our lives. The sum of Nicholas's choices makes it abundantly clear that he is not your typical trust fund baby, content to revel in his riches. However abnormal they may have been, the sum of his choices is an intriguing, exciting life filled with purpose. His words are true. We are all dealt a hand of cards when we come into this world. We make the choices with those cards, whether conventional choices or head-tilting ones. You can choose to establish a permanent home or live a homeless nomadic life, traveling from place to place. Your hand of cards changes from time to time. You add some cards and you trade some cards in for different ones. But at the end of the road, your life is defined by what you do with your cards. So, what is the sum of your choices now? What do you want the sum of your choices to be? Take some advice from the homeless billionaire and do something extraordinary with the cards you've been dealt. Thanks for watching Cerebral Life, the channel where you learn more and improve your life. See you next time.